Hey everyone, my name is Aki and I'm a Siberian Tuban currently living in Buenos Aires, Argentina. This week is a Pride Week in Buenos Aires and I thought why don't I share my personal story of being gay and living in one of the most criminal and isolated regions of Russia. This video is also a coming out video because many people don't know that I'm gay. Yeah, so let's get started. Generally, Russia is known for being a really homophobic country where the topic of being gay usually is not talked about. Recent polls also indicate that the vast majority of Russian population, they are against homosexuality and they support laws that discriminate homosexuals. LGBTQA plus people face legal and social challenges that are not experienced by any other people. And the situation can get even much more worse with accepting the new law which bans everything that is related to LGBTQ plus topic. Pretty much being gay will equal to pornography or to promoting violence or to provoking some racial, ethnical or religious tensions, and those convicted will face really large fines. The situation with being gay can differ from one region to another depending like where you live. In a big cities like Moscow or St. Petersburg, it's much more safer, people are more open-minded, and you can pretty much live your gay life and don't be scared that someone's gonna, you know, find you and beat you up or even kill you. There are some other regions that are far away from the central part of Russia, really isolated. For example, the place where I was born and raised, Republic of Tuva, where the situation with being gay is much more dangerous. The Republic of Tuva is located in the southern part of Siberia. It has a border with Mongolia, and Tuvan people are a Turkic ethnic group indigenous to Siberia. They've pretty much been traditionally living a nomadic sort of lifestyle, and pastoralism and hunting are their traditional occupation. So in this patriarchy society with a macho masculinity, it's really hard to be gay, not just be open about your sexual orientation, but even discovering who you are because you don't have any representation among the society. Tuva is also known for being the most criminal and one of the most poorest regions of Russia. I'm 27 years old and I've had quite a bit journey to come up to the state where I am right now, to be proud and happy gay, and this is my personal story. I was born in a middle class family. My dad was a trucker who would occasionally get drunk and be aggressive, which is quite normal for a Tuvan family to have a father alcoholic. And my mother, she worked as a tax inspector and now she's retired. I was growing up as a really emotional, empathic and sweet boy. I used to hang out mostly with girls because I was vibing with them. I would play like girl games, Barbie, and gossip and chat and stuff like this. I used to have really thin voice and quite feminine gestures, which didn't catch a lot of people's attention because for a young boy of that age, it's quite usual to have these kind of characteristics. So it was pretty much fine. I didn't get punished or anything. During kindergarten period, I kind of fell in love with this boy. Let's just name him Jamie for now. So I had really deep and romantic sort of feelings towards him, which has never happened before to anyone else. And after kindergarten, we went to the same school. We studied in one class until sixth grade. And during this time, I was madly in love with Jamie. I used to have this notebook where I would like fantasize about our romance, and I would put really cute stickers and make up stories as if we were living together as a couple. And there was also a time when I would put my mother's makeup on in order to look way more beautiful and, you know, just to catch his attention. We were good friends and we would hang out a lot, and I enjoyed it a lot. During this period of time, I didn't quite understand that a boy cannot be in love with another boy in that society, and that's why I was quite expressive with my feelings to that guy. Obviously, my parents knew that something is wrong, and I think at that time there was this really popular practice. I read it on this psychologist like website or something, where they would recommend parents to find like a CD disc or something with the pornography and hide it somewhere in the house, and then give a chance for your kid to find that CD disc and play it and watch it and sort of get an idea what his role should be. So pretty much my house was full stuck with like pornography CD disc that I was finding, like, you know, finding all the time, and yeah, I was watching a lot of it. But obviously it didn't do anything. So then I moved to the boarding school. During the boarding school, I started kind of blending with the majority of people, like with others. I would like hide my true self, control my emotions, control my intentions, control my feelings. And I was quite feeling unhappy. I felt like I have some problems, like, you know, my mind has some problems. I was also bullied a lot, and there was one time when a guy who is like 3 grades older than me humiliated me in front of all the boys that were living at the boarding school. He would put me in the center of the circle and beat me, demand me speaking like more masculine, which obviously I couldn't do, and he just kept beating me. Also, during this time, my fellow students, they started dating girls and thought that I should also do that, and kind of dated a girl. I was kind of lost and I didn't know like what my life is going to be. During the 10th grade, I was lucky and won an exchange program to go to study abroad in the United States for 1 year. During this time period, I met a lot of amazing people, and I was living with Cabreja family, the best family in the United States. They kind of allowed me to be my true self. So, you know, I would dress up in really colorful clothes with like flower patterns, which is like something unacceptable if you wear in Tuva. And I will also dye my hair, allow myself, my body move freely to have my sort of feminine gestures. And yeah, and then they were really supportive, and I felt that I'm really welcomed and I felt secure. And that's when I started realizing that maybe I'm gay, and I had an access to other people. I met like gay couples there, and I thought like, oh my gosh, this is possible. Like, you know, I'm not something crazy, and then I'm not, say, a sick person. It's just a normal thing. So this is how I kind of discovered my sexuality. And then I went back to Russia, and again I started living kind of this don't talk, don't ask sort of a lifestyle. So during like my bachelor, when I was doing my bachelor, I didn't really pay attention to my sexual orientation because I was studying. I didn't have time to like, you know, I don't know, to date or anything. I didn't even think about it because I was busy, yeah, with activities, with studying and all that stuff. But I had this idea in my head all the time that I will have to move to another country in order to be my true self, And I was kind of working towards that. So I plan ahead that like at the end of the bachelor degree, I will do coming out to my mother and my close friends, and then I will go to abroad to do my master's. So on my senior year, on my graduation day, my mom came to the city where I was studying, and I actually planned everything out really smoothly. So I paid for everything while she was staying there, and she got the idea that her son is a good person. Like I had all these honors and I'm on a good path, and she was really proud of me. And I used this kind of time to, you know, present myself in a new aspect, saying that like, "Mom, I am gay." Surprisingly, wasn't really shocking to her. She was quite sad when I told her, but we had this really deep conversation where we kind of found the basis of our understanding, and she accepted me as a gay person, and I was the happiest person ever. I came back to Tuva to spend the summer with my family before my master's. And during this time, I met other Tuvan gay people for the first time, because before that, I wouldn't even imagine there are some other people like me living here. And so I met these people. They were much older than me. Like I was 23 at that time, and then they were about 30 to like 35 to 40 years old. And I was really shocked by this story, just the way they live, because they are living really like, you know, secret life. They hide everything from everyone. It's a constant fear that someone's gonna know that you are gay, and then they reveal it to others, and then you might get, I don't know, beaten up, or you will be, anything could happen to you. I don't even want to think about that. And I kind of felt really sorry for them that they had to do it. And me, because I was going to China to do my master's, I was believing that I'm gonna have a better life, and you know, I'm going to have a love relationship with someone. So I went to China, and China, I think, is much more open towards gays. There is no fear that someone's gonna come and beat you up and maybe kill you, because in Russia there is such a fear, and then there is this kind of cases where people die. In China, I've been having new experiences, having fun, and maybe dated some people, and I got mature in myself. When you came out as a gay, it's just the beginning of the journey, because there is a lot of things also involved in being a gay person. I've been experiencing myself, finding what I want to do and stuff like this. In 2018, during the COVID, I came back to Russia, and this is where my first relationship happened. I met this guy on a dating app, and we had a really nice conversation and dated for a little bit, and I was falling in love with him, but I wasn't getting sort of a reassurance for him, like, does it mean the same thing for him, or does he want to be in a relationship? And ask him, like, you know, can we talk about all these? And he told me that we can't be together because he was too scared of being open, not just being open, just even the idea of that he can be with another person, another guy. And he told me that he can't come, like, be open to his family and friends, because he doesn't want to lose them. If he says that if he told them, they will just, you know, reject him. And I felt really sad, and I felt like, does it all have to be like this? Why just a person can't be happy? And this is like what general idea of gay people in Russia, I guess, because they just want to, like, you know, have sex and have a secret life, and so that no one would know about them, and they don't have the bravery to fight for their love, like, and have a sweet and loving relationship. It's something they think maybe not worth fighting for. So then I moved to Moscow. This is where I started working, and I met another guy, and he really showed me the another part of the like being gay. And in Moscow, you, as I told you before, you can be pretty much open and no one's gonna hurt you or anything. And this was time of romance. It was time of like love. We kiss on a metro, like subway elevator, hold our hands while we walk on the streets. At the beginning, I was kind of scared because it was something new for me, and I was scared actually for him because I was thinking maybe some just crazy guy would come up and then like you know beat him or like stab him or anything. And but having him with me, I kind of felt secure and supported, and I allow myself to feel these feelings, you know, to be romantic because it also needs your bravery. When you live in a country like Russia. So yeah, and now I'm in Argentina, and when every human's rights are protected and you're not scared of being open with your sexual orientation. And I really worry about the future of Russia, and I really worry about the younger generation because I don't want them to go through what I went. I want them to have an easier and happier life where they can be whoever they want to be. And I really hope that the war will end and the government will change and there will be democracy, they will respect human rights, and everyone can be free and the victory of love. I hope that it will happen. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope it wasn't too long. And yeah, see you in the next video. Bye.